Dear rail lovers, welcome to Railways Explained. Today, we start a series of videos dedicated to a topic that is now relevant more than ever before: innovations in railway traffic. When we say innovation, we mean a long list of technological breakthroughs that have been happening to the railways in recent years. Among other, there are zero-emission hydrogen trains, advanced autonomous trains able to handle even emergency situations, drone-based automation of infrastructure maintenance, implementation of 4G technology in train management system, implementation of big data technology for improving the safety, security and reliability of rail infrastructure, artificial intelligence used for real-time traffic simulations and delay forecasting, variable railway bogies allowing a single train to operate at two or even more different track gauges, and many, many other. There's a good reason why innovations find their way to railways so easily. On one hand, rail technology continues to develop as rail customers are demanding faster, safer, and more reliable service, while on the other, the railway system is, by definition, suitable for automation of certain processes due to the fact that the freedom of movement of trains is, well, taken away by the rails. However, as this aspect of railways has been always super interesting to us, we decided to share with you some thoughts and to introduce you with the recent trends in this field. As, of course, it is impossible to cover all rail-related technological breakthroughs and innovation trends in one single video, we are now going to speak only about two: decarbonization and automation of infrastructure maintenance. In the next video in this series, our intention is to discuss the application of 4G technology in traffic management systems and the recent developments in the field of gauge-changing trains. Now, let's start. Decarbonization of the transport sector has already become one of the top priorities of the European Union agenda. Despite the fact that today the railway network of Europe is dominantly electrified, still 20% of the total traffic and around 40% of the main railway network is still served by diesel technology. Having in mind that electrification of remaining diesel lines is the process requiring significant financial resources, in the coming decades Europe intends to completely replace diesel locomotives with the currently available alternative: fuel cell and hydrogen trains. This technology is flexible, zero-emission, and potentially cost-effective replacement for diesel combustion engines. Hydrogen trains use the chemical energy of hydrogen for propulsion by taking the advantage of the reaction of hydrogen and oxygen in a fuel cell to run electric motors. Several countries, such as the UK, Netherlands, and Austria, have, to a certain degree, already been involved in developing and testing of hydrogen trains. However, two hydrogen-powered trains built by Alstom already came into commercial operation in Germany in September 2018. They provide passenger service between the cities whose names we're not even trying to pronounce in the federal state of Lower Saxony. Furthermore, more similar trains are expected to run on this network since the state has ordered 14 new Coradia iLint models from Alstom, which is, by the way, the world's first commercial and fully licensed hydrogen-powered train. These trains, in terms of performance, are quite competitive with trains powered by internal combustion engines, achieving a top speed of 140 km per hour. The roof of Coradia iLint train is equipped with a fuel cell and a pressure tank, where the hydrogen is stored in a gaseous form. The fuel cell generates energy by combining the stored hydrogen with oxygen from ambient air. This energy is then used to power the train's traction drive and various onboard systems, such as air conditioning, doors, lights, information displays, etc. The surplus energy generated by the fuel cell and the kinetic energy recovered during the braking is stored in the lithium-ion batteries, fitted in the lower sections of the train. These models are currently being refueled using a mobile hydrogen filling stations. A fuel tank enables a train to operate roughly 1,000 km, which is in general enough for the full day operation. As we already mentioned, since the electrification of the whole network requires significant amounts of money and time, we believe that introducing the hydrogen-powered trains is a fair and sustainable option in terms of global concerns with respect to global warming and decarbonization. However, an important issue still remains open. Since the traction power is still relatively low, this technology is currently used for the traction of passenger trains only. Regarding the freight transport, it is still not fully clear whether hydrogen trains will be able to provide enough pulling power for moving heavy loads, especially over the longer distances. Having in mind that suitability for passenger transport has already been demonstrated, innovators are now shifting their focus to developing hydrogen fuel technology suitable for heavy freight trains. In any case, rail experts have no doubt that the decision to gradually abandon diesel locomotives and start using alternative fuels will eventually revolutionize rail transport. By doing research for this video, especially the segment of innovations in the field of rail infrastructure maintenance, we realized that we had not yet discussed nor explained the process of infrastructure maintenance. But we promise to correct ourselves in the coming period. And now we're going to talk about drones. Yes, you heard right. Drones have a great potential in the process of rail infrastructure maintenance. As most of you already know, it is still widely accepted practice that the condition of rail infrastructure is monitored by the railway workers, mostly based around walking and visual inspection. These railway workers go along the tracks with the task to check if everything works fine. If, for example, they notice certain damages on the track that can have impact on the safety of the railway traffic, they fix it on site. Or, if needed, they call the specialized crew to deal with the problem. In order to minimize the impacts of all risks which are associated with this process, a range of safety protocols and procedures had to be introduced. But this still remains the time-consuming process requiring involvement of a large amount of workforce, and a process which is not, as such, resilient to human errors. Furthermore, some assets such as bridges, culverts or tunnels are by definition confined spaces, and as such, they require additional safety training and human resource requirements which need to be met before the inspections even take place. On the other side, drones equipped with high-resolution cameras, sensors and scanners can enable precise infrastructure inspections and they can carry out risky activities previously performed by human staff. This includes working at heights and access to dangerous locations such as roofs, bridges, coastal areas, overhead wires and communication masts, which are all the cases in which this innovation enables monitoring and inspection from a safe location. Basically, drones gather data, videos and images of the railway infrastructure elements, and when the problem is spotted, the railway workers can better understand it and to make a decision what kind of intervention they need to carry out on the field. The British infrastructure manager Network Rail has already used drones equipped with heat-sensitive 4K camera as useful support for track maintenance. Also, Deutsche Bahn is planning to make the use of this drone technology regular in the coming period, with the aim to make infrastructure inspections both cost-effective and more efficient. Unfortunately, we came to an end of this video. Having in mind that we will continue this series dedicated to innovations in railway traffic, we will conclude this video with a small discussion about the definition of innovation. If, for example, you ask Google for the definition of innovation, you'll come up with over 300 million results with thousands of definitions. Its own definition is pretty much useless. It says that the innovation is the action or process of innovating. Using the traditional sources for a definition, such as the Oxford Dictionary, also doesn't help much, with their definition being make changes in something established, especially by introducing new methods, ideas, or products. However, we managed to find one that seemed quite appropriate. It reads, very simply put, innovation is about staying relevant. We are in a time of unprecedented change. As a result, what may have helped an organization be successful in the past could potentially be the cause of their failure in the future. Companies need to adapt and evolve to meet the ever-changing needs of their constituents. That's what it's all about. This was Railways Explained. We hope you enjoyed and learned something new about the railways of the world. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your rail-loving friends, and of course, subscribe to our channel. Until the next time, goodbye.